Hello, good morning everyone. Today I will cover some questions I received by email where we will see how to create signals and also a filter. On this example, we want several lines aligned, like these ones. This is an exponential moving average, the slowest of the five moving average, and this is the fastest moving average. And when we have all of them aligned from the fastest to the slowest, and this happens here on this bar, we have all lines aligned. So this will be a signal to enter short, or also a condition to allow short signals. For example, on a pullback, we can take this pullback, or this pullback. And of course, when the alignment is no longer in place, like here, then we stop taking trades if we are using this as a filter. And for the long, on this bar, we have all lines aligned from the fastest to the slowest. So again, this could be an entry signal, or also the start for a long filter allowing, for example, entries on a pullback. This is part of a setup that I received on a question on an email that we can see now on the chart. We can see later this time frame. This is not the same that we are using here. But let's go first to the first part. How to detect the alignment of several lines. On this example is are moving average, but this works for any type of line, using of course marker plus tools. First of all, we need to copy all these lines. So we go to marker, copy, and copy the first line. The first line is a moving average of a period of 21. We assign a name, EMA21, and on input series, we place the indicator with the settings to copy. If we click on apply, we can see that in dotted line, we are using a dotted line, we can see the copied version of the fastest line. But we on for this example, I don't want to show the copied line because it is already there. So we do the same for all the other four lines. Markers copy, EMA 34 on input series, EMA 34. Don't show the copied line. Again, another marker copy. 55. Don't show the line. Another marker copy. 89. 89. Don't show the copied line. And the last one, marker copy. 144. And that's all. Don't show the copied line. Okay. So now we have all the lines copied into a markers variable. The markers variable is EMA21, 34, and so on. And now we need to calculate the distance between the fast and the following. So we have 5 lines and we need to calculate 4 distances. When all of the distances are positive, that means that we have all of them aligned to the downside. If all the distances are negative, like here, that means that we have an alignment to the upside. To measure the distance between two lines, we use the crossover. And we need to measure 4 distances. So we use 4 crossover indicators. Crossover between EMA 21 and 34. The name of the result, EMA21 minus EMA34. If we click on apply, we can see the distance is negative because the red line is below the yellow line. And on 0, the distance is 0 when both are when one is crossing the other. It also paints signals on the crossovers, these signals, but for this setup we don't need those signals, so we can avoid to paint the crossovers. We don't want these arrows. And now we do the same for the second distance. Another markers crossover. But now between EMA 34 and the following, that is 55. And the name 34 minus 55, and don't paint signals. We get another histogram with the distance between the yellow and the orange. Also, we get a crossover on this bar, this crossover. And we do the same with the other two distances. Markers crossover between 55 and 89. Don't paint signals. And the last crossover between the 89 and 144. Without painting signals. So now we have 4 histograms, the 4 distances. When all of them are negative, this is this crossover, then we have another, and on this point here we have the 4 lines aligned all to the downside. On the other side, when all of them are positive, here we have the first crossover, second crossover, third crossover, and finally on this bar we have an agreement. All the four lines, the five lines, are trending to the upside. To save space, we can place all of them together. And when we get all blue, this is a signal where we have an agreement. When all is blue, all lines are in agreement. Here we have something in disagreement because the red line crosses below here. And for the short side, on this bar, all are red, corresponding to this bar. And here we have a disagreement because the red line started to go to the upside and crossed the yellow line. So now with this setup we can filter shorts from here, to here. We can enable short signals. Same here. And here we can enable long signals. And if we use this event, this confluence, as an entry signal, we can enter on the first time that they are all in agreement. Like here, we can enter short here and enter long here. So to detect this event when all are trending down or when all are trending up, we need to use the AND indicator. And this is already typed here. On the variable names, we place the distances. The distance between the EMA 21 and the EMA 34 has a minimum of 0. The other distances has also a minimum of 0. The four distances has a minimum of 0. So all of them are positive. That will be here, all this. And when all of these conditions are true, we place the result on a new variable, for example, longs. And we have the option to paint a signal. Let's say that we paint a signal the first time it happens. And to make it more clear, we can paint a vertical line in color green. So we can see this is the signal that all lines, the first time that all lines are in agreement. And also the result, this is the result, the histogram longs, has a value of plus one because it is true. If we want to create the condition for shorts, we need to do the same. We need another instance of this indicator, but instead of a minimum, a maximum of zero. So all the instances are negative. To avoid typing all the variable names again, we can save this as default. And when we add an AND indicator, now we get all the settings with the same value. So we only need to change, instead of a minimum, a maximum, of 0 instead of a minimum, a maximum. Same for all variables. And now I can place again a signal the first time that that happens, but in color red. The result, we get another histogram. The result, let's call it shorts. This result will have two possible values, plus one if all the conditions are true, or minus one if any of those conditions is not true. And this is what we get. We can see that starting here, we have the signal for the first time that happens. All the lines are aligned. And on this point, something is not aligned. We can see this on this arrow. Here we have two bars, only two bars with both with the five lines aligned, but then everything is mixed again. And here we have again another signal. So now we have the option to use this as a filter or as an entry signal. If we want to enter short when the first time that all lines are aligned, we can configure this this signal on markers. We can use a better signal instead of a vertical line. This is the AND for the longs. And we can place no signals at all, no signals, so we don't get the vertical line, or we can place a signal each time that the conditions are true, so we get a signal on all these bars. Now, for this example, we want to enter only the first time, so we paint the first time that all the conditions are true, and I want below the bar an arrow up in color blue. For the shorts, I want the first time above the bar an arrow down in color red. And now we get this long signal and these short signals. If we want to automate these signals, we can use marker plus and configure arrow up in color blue to enter long, and for the shorts, arrow down in color red. For this example, we can enter at market. So now let's say that we want to use this alignment as a filter, not as an entry signal. So again, we need to go to the AND indicators and remove the signals. Not painting arrows on the shorts or on the longs. So now we don't have any entry signal. We only want the enter longs when this is true, This is plus one. And shorts when this is plus one. This variable is shorts and the other variable is longs. By now, let's place something that paints signals. For example, the end bars. This indicator paints a signal each time there is a color change. And now let's say that I only want to take those signals when the five lines are aligned. How can I do that? I use this variable to enable longs and this variable to enable shorts. So I go to markers. And enable filters. Instead of taking all the signals, I will filter the signals. And the name of the signal for the longs is this one. And the name is longs. We assigned that name on the AND indicator. So we can use we place the variable here and we want to be true. When it is true, the value is plus one. So I want a minimum value of one. For the shorts, the name of the variable is also shorts. So the variable is shorts. And when it is true, it has a minimum value of plus one. So minimum one. And I remove the maximum. So condition for longs, long has a minimum of one. Condition for shorts, shorts has a minimum of one. And now we are ready. We are trading only, on this example, we are trading not this arrow, because here longs are not enabled, but we trade this, and this, and this. And for the shorts, starting from here, we trade this short, this short, this short, and ignore all the longs. Okay, hope this video has been useful for you, and if you have any question, please post below. Thank you, everyone. Bye bye.